This is Curriculum Instruction Committee on August 22nd, 2022, starting at 6:06 p.m. This is Mrs. Bell. Mrs. Albright is absent. Ms. Leone is present, and Ms. Thompson is present, as well as Dr. Cooper and Mrs. Owens. On the discussion topics, the summer professional learning enrollment.
Hello there.
Hi.
So, actually, in the last committee meeting, Mr. Matz brought up this same exact topic, but I'm going to bring it up too because it's very exciting. So, our summer professional learning, this is where we had made professional development voluntary for the teachers, and we, you know, it was the first year we ever did this, so we didn't know what to expect, and we were thinking, all right, maybe 20 teachers will sign up, and this would be a good start, but 63 individual teachers participated, and in a total of 133 sessions. So I think that is unbelievably successful, and everyone was very positive about it. They're so excited to be able to hit the ground running with their classrooms. It was everything from just using their devices, refreshers, to the new LMS, to a lot of people change their learning management systems this year because, you know, with Schoology now for the intermediate center and Blackboard for the older kids. So it really, also what it did was it freed up teachers' time this week. You know, we have three in-service days this week, and it just freed up their time because they don't have to work on that now. They can load the curriculum and kind of get into the nuts and bolts of their teaching. So again, very exciting.
August 22nd update on the first day of school for our teachers and professional staff.
So that was today. We are very excited that our kicked off today with our first in-service day. The teachers were all back in full swing, getting connected with one another, and you know, we really wanted to make sure we kicked off this year in a positive way that really helped to continue that positive school culture that we really care about and focus on connections and relationship building and mental health, physical health, and so far I've heard nothing but positive feedback. We will be doing a formal survey on today's events, but so far it's been really good feedback.
Math K through 12 meeting again to look at vertical alignment.
Yeah, so back in March, I did mention that we got the K-12 math folks together to take a look at our vertical alignment of our math curriculum, and so we are just continuing that this week as we get the group together again. And the K-12 STEM group will also get together for a second or third time, I think it is now, to continue their work on our STEM curriculum and discuss ways to continue integrating STEM into our current.
Unfinished learning report from PDE.
Yep, so this is a report that was put together by PDE, and I just wanted to bring it up. Everybody got this report that was specific to your district, and they were trying to support districts in their work surrounding the unfinished teaching and learning due to the pandemic. So they took students from the 18-19 school year, and they determined their projected scores on PSSA and Keystones. And then those projected scores were compared to what they actually scored in 2021. So, you know, lagging data, just that in perspective. But then the effect size, once they do all that, shows that there's a significant difference. Well, there was in a lot of the subjects and a lot of the grades, but I kind of try to summarize it. I do have the printout of the report if anybody's interested in looking at it, but I summarized it for you. According to our results, the most negatively affected area was math in grade 8, followed by algebra 1, math grades 5 and 7, ELA grades 5, 7, and 8, and science. So areas that we see only a small difference and that did actually vary well were grade 6 math, grade 6 ELA, and fall short of the scores that they would have been expected if there was not a pandemic. So, but you know what? That's how every school is seeing that. So it's not surprising, even though our intention was to not see any difference due to the pandemic, unfortunately, that did not happen. But what this data is going to help us with is kind of where to go from here. So our individual schools and our buildings and our teachers can look at that data and see where they need to go from there.
And we have new staff induction.
Yes, we welcomed 21 new staff to the district on August 16, 17, and 18. And it was a very excited, energized group, all young, new teachers that are changing career people. They were an excellent group, brought a lot of energy. We had presentations by our special ed department, Department of Community Relations and Equity Awareness, our instructional coaches, our principals came and met with the new teachers, our mentors were with them on the 18th, and Price Transportation donated a bus and a driver so that our new staff could tour the district, and the teachers really, really appreciated taking the tour of the entire district. It was about an hour long, and they just said it really made them feel part of the community and, you know, excited to greet these their new students knowing what their community looked like.
Thank you.
Yep, thank you.
Anything else to add? Okay, that is the end of curriculum instruction at 6:13 p.m.